So we have observed the oscillating neutral concept of oscillating neutral. I am going to explain you further. Now please observe here. We have a fluxes that is fundamental, fifth, seventh and so on, and the fluxes are rotating in nature. So these fluxes, when we are rotating the rotor, it means the fluxes are rotating, but all the fluxes are not rotating towards the direction of fundamental. All 6m minus 1s are rotating in the opposite direction to the fundamental, while 6m plus 1 odd harmonics are rotating in the direction of fundamental. So now please observe, you can say, sir, the rotating flux cuts the stator conductor and induces EMF in the stator conductor. Now please observe here, we have a stator conductor, okay. So the induced EMF per phase, that is line to neutral, is fundamental induced EMF plus, you can say, sir, third harmonic induced EMF plus fifth harmonic induced EMF plus seventh harmonic induced EMF and so on of A phase. Similarly, fundamental induced EMF plus third harmonic induced EMF, fifth harmonic induced EMF, seventh harmonic induced EMF in B phase, and similarly fundamental plus third plus fifth plus seventh harmonic induced EMF in C phase. So you can say, sir, this EA is basically equals to this, and this EB is basically equals to all of this, EC is basically equals to all of this. So the induced EMF obtained is not sinusoidal, but this is non-sinusoidal induced EMF we are obtaining due to the space harmonics. Now please see, if the fundamental flux is rotating in a clockwise direction, then the phase sequence of induced EMF will be, if you observe here, the fundamental flux is rotating in the phase sequence, you can say, A, C, B. So if the fundamental is cutting A phase first, then B phase, then C phase, then you can say, sir, induced EMF phase sequence will become, for fundamental induced EMF, fundamental induced EMF, that is induced EMF due to the fundamental field, is first it cuts A phase, then after 120 degree of rotation it cuts B phase, then after C phase, then after 120 degree of rotation it cuts B phase. So the phase sequence of induced EMF is ACB, and if you observe, fifth harmonic induced EMF, so fifth harmonic induced EMF will have the phase sequence of, you can say, sir, fifth harmonic flux is rotating in the opposite direction, and fifth harmonic flux is rotating in the opposite direction, and you can say first it cuts A phase, then it cuts B phase, and then it cuts the C phase. So 0 into 5, you can say that is 0 degree, then it cuts the C phase, 120 into 5, that is equals to say 600, that is 240, and 240 into 5, that is same as 1200, same as 120. So it means the phase sequence is ABC. It means the fundamental is rotating in anti-clockwise, but the fifth harmonic is rotating in a clockwise direction. So accordingly, the induced EMF corresponds to the fifth harmonic, that is fifth harmonic induced EMF. Similarly, seventh harmonic induced EMF, seventh harmonic induced EMF is 0 into 7, that is, you can say, 0 degree, 120 into 7, that is 840, same as 120 degree, and 240 into 7, that is 1680, same as 240, A, C, B, same as fundamental. So you can say the phase sequence of fundamental, if A, B, C, then phase sequence of fifth harmonic induced EMF is A, B, C, and the seventh harmonic induced EMF is A, C, B. So that is opposite to fundamental, same as fundamental. And if you observe the third harmonic that I have represented, this is the reason behind the oscillating neutral in case of a star connected stator. Now please observe, third harmonic induced EMF, third harmonic induced EMF. So you can say, sir, 0 into 3, that is same as 0 degree, 120 into 3, that is same as 0 degree, 240 into 3, that is same as 0 degree. So you can say co-phasal, it means all the induced EMF will come at the same time, that is EA0, EA0, or you can say EA third, EA3, EB3 and EC3 all are appearing at the same instant. However, in this particular case, first we get EA, then EB, then EC, EA, EC, EB, then EA, EB, EC, then for this one EA, EB, EA, EC and EB. Is it okay? So you can say, sir, the fundamental induced EMF and these are different. It is, they are rotating in the different direction. For finding the resultant induced EMF, if all of these induced EMFs are present, we have similarly all 6m plus 1th odd harmonic voltages are in the phase sequence as fundamental, and all 6m minus 1th odd harmonic voltages are opposite to the phase sequence, and all triplen harmonics are co-phasal. So you can say, sir, from this we will come to know about the resultant induced EMF per phase. Now please observe, the resultant per phase induced EMF will become the resultant per phase induced EMF. The resultant per phase induced EMF will become, you can say, sir, fundamental plus third harmonic plus fifth harmonic plus seventh harmonic. So that can be represented as fundamental, I can represent it as EAF, that is fundamental square, plus E third harmonic EA3 plus of EA5, that is A phase fifth harmonic voltage, similarly A phase seventh harmonic voltage square. So this will give the magnitude of the per phase induced EMF of A phase, okay, similarly for B phase, similarly for a C phase. Is it okay? Now please observe, you can say, sir, the fundamental induced EMF along with the odd harmonic voltages will give this as the magnitude of phase voltage as A phase, similarly B phase, similarly C phase. Now please observe, if you found that fundamental induced EMFs are EA, EB and EC, that is fundamental induced EMF. If you observe the fundamental induced EMF, they are 120 degree apart, similarly 5th and 7th also are 120 degree apart. But triplen harmonic is very dangerous. If we consider a triplen harmonic voltage, that is E3, then E3 for all the three phases, it will induces at the same time. So this is not displaced in time. However, all these induced EMF, that is fundamental, 5th and 7th, are displaced in time by 120 degree. So let us suppose for a moment that induced EMF E3 at some instant is available here. Then you can say this will be your EC, EC, that is equals to ECN. If this is N, then you can say ECN plus of E3. Is it okay? Similarly, you can say EA, EA is equals to EAN plus of E3. As third harmonic is co-phasal, so for all the phases, this will be the third harmonic. Similarly, your EB is equals to EBN plus of E3. Is it okay? So you can say this will be the third harmonic. Due to third harmonic, this will be the induced EMF. So you found that the induced EMF is peaky in nature. Now third harmonic will have the frequency of 3 omega and fundamental will have a frequency of omega. It means this neutral point is changing its position by twice of the supply frequency. So this represent that at one portion C phase is maximum, at another instant your B phase will become maximum, A phase and C phase will get down. At some other instant you can say A phase will become maximum, C phase and B phase is going to be down. You can say, sir, the third harmonic or triplen harmonics are only present in phase, it is not present in line. So you can say, sir, if we observe line voltage, that is EAB, then this will be equals to EA minus EB. So you can say, sir, EA is equals to EAN plus of E3 and minus of EBN plus of E3. All the third triplen harmonics are co-phasal, so E3, E3 will cancel out and this will become EAN minus EBN, that is your EAB. So you can say, sir, the line to line voltages are not changing. The line to line voltages are fixed, but the phase voltages are being increased, or you can say it becomes peaky, and the peakiness is changing with respect to time. It means for a small time, EFA phase is higher. For another time, B phase will become higher. Another time, C phase will become higher. And it is the change in this having high magnitude of one phase is with the double frequency of the fundamental. So you can say, sir, with this type of supply, we can't fed single phase load. Because what happens if we fed to a single phase load, suddenly the voltage will become very high and suddenly the voltage will become very low. And that is very dangerous for the electrical devices, especially rotating induction machines, especially for the induction machines, which are the basic loads for all electrical consumptions. Okay, now please see. You know that, sir, the harmonic voltages can be found in the per phase basis in this way. The triplet harmonics are dangerous appearing because with the triplet harmonics, mixed loading is not going to be possible. However, if we design the phase spread of 120 degree electrical, which is only possible in case of double layer winding, then you can say, sir, all triplet harmonics can be avoided. Now, please see the advantage of phase spread equals to 120 degree electrical. Please see, advantage of phase spread 120 degree electrical. Advantage of phase spread to be equals to 120 degree electrical. So, if we use the phase spread of 120 degree electrical, then distribution factor will become, distribution factor is equals to, you can say, sir, sine phase spread by 2 upon m sine phase spread by 2. For nth harmonic component, you can say, sir, kd for nth harmonic component will become sine n phase spread by 2 upon n phase spread by 2, or you can say in this way also, that is m sine n phase spread by 2 into m. Is it okay? Now, if phase spread is equals to 120 degree electrical, then this will become sine 120, you can say, sir, 3 into 120 by 2 upon 3m sine, whatever will be the this will become 3 into 120 by 2 into m. So, whenever you calculate, this will be equals to 0. So, if we design the phase spread of a 3 phase winding to be equals to 120 degree, then triplet harmonics are automatically going to be 0. The triplet harmonic voltages are automatically going to be 0, and the problem of oscillating neutral will be resolved. So, generally, we prefer a 3 phase machine to design with a phase spread of 120 degree electrical. But remember that phase spread of 120 degree electrical is only possible in case of double layer winding. Is it okay? Now, see, once we have phase spread of this, then all triplet harmonics will become 0. In this particular case, if you have to find the phase voltage, then in this phase voltage, you can say, sir, in this phase voltage, sir, you can say that fundamental is present, okay, fifth harmonic is present, seventh harmonic is present, yes, but the triplet harmonics, the third harmonic will become 0, as third harmonic winding factor suggests the third harmonic induced DMF will become 0. Is it okay? Now, please see, you can say, sir, if the machine is of delta connected, then what happens? For star connected, the greatest advantage is that now we can fed single phase as well as 3 phase load. But if the machine is delta connected and then we are designing with a phase spread of 60 degree, then please observe, for a delta connected stator, we never connect the stator of an alternator in delta. Instead of connecting delta, we always prefer star so that we can fed a mixed loading, that is single phase as well as 3 phase users can be supplied by the star connected alternators. However, let us consider about the delta connected stator. Delta connected stator. If we use delta connected stator, then you can say, sir, in case of delta connected stator, If we rotate the rotor, then per phase induced EMF will be equals to fundamental plus third harmonic plus fifth harmonic plus seventh harmonic and so on. Is it okay? So similarly for A phase, similarly for B phase, similarly for a C phase in case of a delta connected alternator, if the space harmonics are present. Now please observe, you can say, sir, if we find the value of here, because of the triplet harmonics are present, these triplet harmonics causes circulating current, and that current will be circulates within the winding, and that will created the heat effect in the winding. You can say, sir, third harmonic will get path to flow through this as a circulating current. Star connected is possible with a phase spread of 120 degree. And one more thing, that in case of a star connected stator, the third harmonic will not get path to flow. Is it okay? Or it flows only when the neutral is grounded or connected. However, in this particular case delta, your circulating current exists because of the triplet harmonics. If the triplet harmonics are not zero, then circulating current will become equals to, you can say, sir, fundamental induced EMF upon X1 plus of third harmonic induced EMF upon X3, that is a reactance corresponding to third harmonic. Similarly, fifth harmonic by X5, you can say triplet and fundamental, so you may represent in this way, that is third harmonic component, fifth harmonic component. Again, I am representing for a delta connected stator, because of the triplet harmonics are present. So these triplet harmonic EMF causes circulating current, and that increases the heat in the delta connected winding. This lowers the overall efficiency of the alternator if the alternator is connected in delta. One more thing, we cannot supply a mixed loading, we can only supply a balanced three phase load. Is it okay? Now please observe here how we can calculate the value of circulating current. Okay, right. Now please see, in case if a delta connected stator is being used with a phase spread of 60 degree, then KD for triplet harmonics, you can say third harmonic, is not equals to zero. In that particular case, you can say, since the third harmonic voltages are co-phasal, so they are going to create a circulating current in the delta connected winding. So what is the magnitude of that circulating current? Please observe, this circulating current IC is equals to this induced EMF A phase, B phase and C phase. Since they are co-phasal, so this will become three times of induced third harmonic induced EMF divided by, you can say, sir, X of reactance of this winding, reactance of this winding and reactance of this winding. So this is three times of the reactance X3. Similarly, you can say for a circulating plus of ninth harmonic induced EMF. Ninth harmonic induced EMF is again EA9, EB9 and EC9. So all are co-phasal. So three times of E9 by 3X9 and so on. So you can say that 3-3 will be cancelled out, and you may represent in this way. Since the values of these induced EMF upon harmonics are very small, as the induced EMF for nth harmonic is 1 by n square times of fundamental, so you can say these are very high. So all the addition is nearly equals to X3 by 3 only, E3 by X3 only, where E3 by X3 is, X3 is representing X corresponding to fundamental is 2 pi FL, where F is the frequency of fundamental induced EMF. Okay. However, the frequency of third harmonic induced EMF is 3 times of fundamental. So, this will become 3X1. So, you can find the value of circulating current. So, due to this circulating current, when circulating current start flowing, soon as this circulating current start flowing in the delta winding, your third harmonic flux is cancelled out. You can say, due to which it was produced as per the Lenz law, and thereby induced EMF, third harmonic induced EMF will become 0. Is it okay? But third harmonic flux will become 0. But the problem is that this circulating current, within the delta winding will causes copper loss, and thereby reducing the efficiency of the machine. Again, please observe, soon as third harmonic current start flowing in delta winding it cancels the third harmonic flux due to which it was produced. As per Lenz's law. As per Lenz's law. And because the third harmonic flux cancels, so third harmonic induced EMF reduces to zero. Is it okay? But the circulating current creates I square R loss and thus efficiency of the machine reduces. But the circulating current increases I square R losses and thus efficiency decreases. Is it okay? So you can say, sir, this triplet harmonics is going to be cancelled out, but that triplet harmonic voltage is cancelled out on the cost of circulating current, and this circulating current reducing the overall, you can say, efficiency of the machine. However, if the delta designed for phase spread of, if the winding is designed with a phase spread of 120 degree, then KD for third harmonic is equals to 0, so there will be no induced third harmonic induced EMF, so no circulating current. But the problem is that in case of delta, you can say, sir, the line voltage and phase voltage are same. The line voltage and phase voltage are same. So, insulation needed will be higher. Let us suppose we have a 11 kV generator. So, insulation required corresponding to the core is equals to 11 kV. However, if the same generator is designed on star, then insulation required will be, if this is of line voltage is of 11 kV, then voltage, the insulation required is corresponding to this voltage level, that you can say 11 kV by root 3, that is phase voltage. So you can say, sir, phase voltage is line voltage by root 3, and this suggests that the insulation cost will be lower in case of a star, insulation cost will be higher in case of delta. This, the neutral point is available, so it can supply single phase as well as three phase load. However, that can only supply a three phase load because the neutral point is absent. Is it okay? So we always construct, we always prefer to design the stator in star for generator. Is it okay?